Are you suffering from pain and stiffness in the shoulder? It may be due to a condition called frozen shoulder. Today, I'll be showing a new procedure called hydrodilatation under ultrasound guidance. Hi, I am Dr.A.K.Venkatachalam. My interests are joint replacement, biologic injections, keyhole surgery and knee replacement. You can learn more about my interests at www.drakvenkat.com. That is drakvenkat.com. A frozen shoulder is a condition characterized by stiffness and pain in the shoulder joint. The condition occurs more commonly in people with diabetes and in people with other conditions of the shoulder itself, like rotator cuff tears, acromioclavicular joint arthritis, glenohumeral joint arthritis, etc. And also with other ailments like heart ailments and systemic diseases. The most common systemic disease associated with the frozen shoulder is diabetes. Women are more commonly affected and the left shoulder is more frequently affected. Both shoulders may be affected in 15% of cases. The underlying cause is tightness of the structures around the shoulder joint without any damage to the bone or articular cartilage. It is due to initial inflammation and subsequent thickening of the shoulder capsule. This leads to pain and stiffness. Pain is worse at night and sleep is disturbed. Pain is triggered unexpectedly during movements of the arm, like for combing hair or raising the arm upwards. Stiffness or restriction of movements is severe. The worst affected is the inability to turn the arm outward like this. This is called external rotation. And the next affected is the inability to lift the arm sideways or upwards. This is called elevation. There are three phases in the disease. A freezing stage, which lasts for a few weeks to several months. Pain is the main feature with progressive restriction of movements. A frozen stage, which lasts from a few weeks to several months. Stiffness is the main symptom. Stiffness is in all direction with external rotation or inability to turn the arm outwards, elevation and backwards. Internal rotation is also affected. The last stage is a resolving stage where stiffness gets better, and this may take up to 5 years. It takes about 5 years to resolve, but even then, patients don't get back their full movements. There is always some permanent restriction of movements. Prevalent treatments are a manipulation under anesthesia and arthroscopic release. I will talk a few lines about these procedures. In a manipulation under anesthesia, obviously the patient is administered anesthesia, usually systemic general anesthesia or regional anesthesia. This procedure is done in the operation theater. In a manipulation under anesthesia, the surgeon manipulates the shoulder or forces it through a range of movements under anesthesia. Usually this is uncomplicated procedure, but sometimes if the person has not used the shoulder, the bones can be weak and an unexpected fracture may occur in the arm bone. Sometimes there may be tearing of the healthy structures, like the important ligaments inside the shoulder joint, or some tendons can also be torn. In an arthroscopic release, which is also done under an anesthesia, like either general or a regional anesthesia, an arthroscope is introduced under regional anesthesia into the shoulder through small incisions. The interior of the shoulder joint is visualized. Usually there is redness of the capsule due to overgrowth of vascular structure in the front of the shoulder joint. the tight structures are released under visualization. Physiotherapy in the form of passive mobilization is commenced and full movements return after a few weeks. Hydrodilatation is a new treatment which involves no regional anesthesia. No cuts are made. It is done as an outpatient procedure in the office or in the operating theater if done under X-ray guidance. A needle is introduced into the shoulder under X-ray or ultrasound guidance. Frozen shoulder is a condition which can be diagnosed and treated under ultrasound guidance. The diagnosis of frozen shoulder by ultrasound is a recent phenomenon. It allows the diagnosis to be done in the doctor's office without the patient having to go and subject themselves to an MRI scan, which can be claustrophobic to some patients. Once you've made the diagnosis, you can inject the shoulder. So today I'm going to show you how you can inject the shoulder from behind with the under ultrasound guidance. So I have got a patient here. I'm taking the probe and I'm positioning the probe on the arm, and I'll show you on the screen the outline of the shoulder joint. So I position the probe on the shoulder joint. This is the ball of the shoulder joint. You can see the shoulder joint moving.
Fluids are injected to distend the joint. Physiotherapy is started soon after and full movements return over a course of 6 weeks. I have done hydrodilatation of the shoulder under X-ray guidance, and you can see the videos here and here. Now I'm going to show you how hydrodilatation of the shoulder is done under ultrasound guidance. It can be done either from the front or back. I prefer to do it from the back. The shoulder joint is visualized and a needle is introduced under ultrasound guidance into the shoulder joint. Medicines are injected into the shoulder joint. This usually consists of steroids. Sometimes botulinum toxin can also be introduced. The tight structures are identified and they can also be released under ultrasound guidance. There are certain tight structures which are very characteristically involved in a frozen shoulder and they can be released. Ultrasound is a very valuable tool to not only diagnose this condition of frozen shoulder and also to treat it under ultrasound guidance. There is no anesthesia involved. Only local anesthesia is given through tiny needles, and the procedure is done in the outpatient or in the operating theater, but no cuts are there. The recovery is hence very rapid. The patient can return home immediately after the procedure and start performing the physiotherapy. The movements are bound to return within a short course of time. I hope that this information will be useful to those patients who are suffering from a frozen shoulder. If you or your relatives are suffering from a frozen shoulder, then you will definitely gain from this knowledge. If you know someone who could also benefit from this treatment, share this video with them. Let me know what treatments you are undergoing for frozen shoulder in the comment section below. If you found this video useful, give it a thumbs up, share it, and subscribe to my channel to keep seeing more videos like this in future. I will see you in the next video. Bye.